your immune system sees those pieces of mitochondria and literally panics. You've probably heard the buzzword autophagy, and that we really need to have more autophagy in our lives. So what exactly is autophagy? Well, let me take you through kind of an end-of-life cell cycle. There's essentially when a cell gets worn out, or a cell gets damaged, or the components of the cell, particularly mitochondria, get damaged, there's one of three possible alternatives. Two of them are really bad for you, and one of them is really good. And if you're guessing autophagy is the good guy, you're right. So autophagy literally means self-eat. Now, that shouldn't sound as scary as it sounds, because self-eat means that when a cell is at the time of death, one system that can go into action is literally the cell recycles all of its various components. All those things you saw in high school biology class, the ribosomes, the Golgi apparatus, the mitochondria, the nucleus, all those things are recycled and basically repackaged into a brand new cell. And that, believe it or not, is a really good thing. The same way mitochondria in the cell can also undergo autophagy, which is called mitophagy. And it's virtually the same process, but it can happen inside the cell without the whole cell undergoing autophagy. And the more we know about mitophagy, the more excited most of us are that that may be one of the real secrets to a long, healthy life. So what are the other alternatives? Well, the worst alternative, they're pretty close, is apoptosis. So apoptosis literally means, rather than kind of recycling all the components, the cell basically explodes. Think about the Death Star exploding from the original Star Wars. And debris goes thrown out into space, into neighboring cell spaces. And that debris is viewed as not only trash, but dangerous trash. Because mitochondria, you may remember, are actually ancient engulfed bacteria. And they contain bacterial DNA and basically the same cell wall as a bacteria. So when the cell explodes and the mitochondria explodes, your immune system sees those pieces of mitochondria and literally panics that bacteria are loose in you and goes on the warpath, causing inflammation. That's the last thing you want to happen when a cell dies. Now, there's another alternative, and you've probably heard me lecture about this. These are zombie cells. The cell doesn't die, but the cell basically sits around in limbo and refuses to function properly. Unfortunately, because it's literally neither dead nor alive, it also promotes inflammation as if it had exploded. And so we know that zombie cells can occur as a process of the end of cell life without really dying. So the two things you don't want is zombie cells or apoptosis. Now, how do you fix that? Well, there's lots of ways to fix that. First of all, my good friend Walter Longo, who's the head of longevity at USC, has shown that the fasting-mimicking diet done for 5 days every month acts as though you were doing a calorie-restricted diet for the entire month. And he's shown that, in fact, it not only promotes autophagy, but it promotes stem cells growing and developing into healthy new cells. So you kind of get a 1-2 punch. Now, I've written about his techniques in multiple of my books. The good news is you can follow a 900-calorie vegan diet for 5 days and achieve exactly the same results. And so once 5 days out of the month, following a calorie-restricted vegan diet will promote both autophagy and stem cell production. Now, let's be clear. Fasting will also promote autophagy and stem cell production. But if you followed my videos on fasting, one of the dangerous things with any prolonged water fast is that within the first 24 hours of fasting, you will try to get fat out of your fat cells. And it just so happens that most of the toxins that are dangerous to us are actually locked safely away in our fat cells. When we begin to break down our fat cells, those heavy metals like mercury, like lead, like arsenic, like organopesticides are released from fat cells. And so you actually, in the process of detoxing, are actually causing toxins to be released into your bloodstream. So I and others have really cautioned against like a 3-day or 5-day or 7-day water fast, primarily for this reason, because sadly, in our environment in North America, we are awash with toxins. And the last thing we want to do is release them from our fat cells. So it's much easier to do a fasting mimicking diet 5 days a week. What's another way to induce autophagy? Well, I've devoted chapters of several of my books to these amino acid proteins that are called polyamines. The most famous of the polyamines is spermidine. I'll give you one guess where that name came from. Yes. And we'll leave it at that. Spermidine and the other polyamines tell cells to undergo autophagy, to self-eat, without doing any fasting, without doing any fasting mimicking diet or other things. And that's the beauty. So where the heck do you find spermidine? Well, most fermented foods, for instance, like sausages, true fermented sausages, true fermented cheeses, true fermented meats in general, produce quite nice amounts of spermidine and other polyamines. And it may be that that's one of the reasons that some of the longest life expectancy in the world is among cultures that actually eat, I kid you not, fermented cultured sausages. Who knew? Or who eat fermented cultured cheeses and milk products. You can also get spermidine in mushrooms. It's in aged soy like miso or natto. And it's also in wheat germ. But word of warning, most of my patients react to wheat germ agglutinin, which is a lectin, and most of them have antibodies to wheat germ agglutinin. So you can get fermented wheat germ, which breaks down wheat germ agglutinin, and these are available as supplements. But one of the easiest ways is to enjoy spermidine in the foods you eat. And if you want more information on that, just check out my video right here on the YouTube channel on spermidine. Finally, exercise will promote autophagy. But here's the deal. It has to be high-intensity interval training or strength training. Running on a treadmill will actually have the reverse effect, something that you don't want. It will actually produce the opposite effect. So, however you want to accomplish HIIT training, however you want to accomplish strength training is fine with me. I've released whole chapters on books on exercise snacking several years ago, and it was kind of fun to see it's just resurfaced as a new thing. Guess what, folks? I introduced the term exercise snacking, and I introduced how you can do it. And these are short, brief intervals of 1 to 2 minutes of bursts of activity. And they're easy to do. There's an entire way of doing them safely and fun ways. I mean, if nothing else, put on your favorite song and bounce around the room for 2 to 3 minutes. That's an exercise snack that you can do. So these are all ways to promote autophagy. Finally, I mentioned when we started mitophagy, recycling mitochondria. Now, mitochondria will recycle when the whole cell recycles. But as I mentioned, you really want damaged mitochondria to recycle within the cell and repair themselves without the whole cell having to reproduce. I'm really excited by a compound called urolithin A. And I'm so excited that I've had 3 podcast episodes devoted to urolithin A. Urolithin A is available as a supplement. Luckily, most super agers have the right set of bacteria to make urolithin A from components primarily in pomegranate, raspberries, and walnuts. Sadly, only about 20% of us have those right set of bacteria to make urolithin A. The good news is urolithin A has been shown to promote mitophagy. And believe me, mitophagy, recycling mitochondria into fresh ones, is one of the real secrets to a long, healthy, active life, just by adding urolithin A into your system. More amazing episodes just like this one. Watch now. The longer you live and the longer you live well. What does that have to do with spermidine?